Hello, my name is Leszek Stomachowski and this is Fitness Soul Podcast. Today we are recording from the car. My name is Leszek Stomachowski and this is Fitness Soul Podcast. Today, a special edition straight from the car. The quality, the sound quality might be not the best, but the chat which we had with Richard was really, really good. You can learn quite a lot of things about diet and fitness. So it's really, really worth to listen to. So just have a sit and enjoy. So where are you flying now? Flying back home? With any plans?
Back to city, airport. The nice thing is my place is like 10 minutes from city airport.
Uh-huh. Oh, that's fantastic.
So get in and then straight on the train, home in 10 minutes.
Uh-huh. And Sunday or relaxing Sunday?
What day is it today?
It must be Sunday.
It is Sunday already, isn't it?
Yeah. Yes, it is.
Maybe with a bit of luck. If I'm lucky, the girlfriend might have made a roast dinner, but well, you never know. Fingers crossed, I'll come in and the smell of chicken or beef will be there. But maybe I've got to make my own.
Is it a small hint for her?
Well, yeah. Sometimes she's pretty cool. Actually, she'll normally make something if she knows I've been away.
And what's tomorrow? Is it starting good? You work.
Tomorrow I'm back in the office tomorrow.
Okay, so it's like 9-5 job you do. Well, what you do basically?
So I've got clients first thing in the morning. Got a couple of clients that I start at 6:30 with, and then I'll train in the morning after them. And then I am in the office from 9:30 till 6 doing my product development role with Fitness Industry Education.
Okay.
So we're currently working on redeveloping our personal training course at the moment, starting from scratch, stripping it out and making it into a course that is fit for purpose. I think there's a lot of personal training courses out there at the moment that are, what's a kind way of saying this? Pretty crap.
Yeah.
You know, where you can sign up and be qualified in 2 weeks, having never demonstrated any kind of competency in front of a qualified tutor or assessor. That's just not great. So we're stripping our course down and we're starting again, and it's going to be a really solid course that helps people train to do the job so that they leave being a competent, confident personal trainer, and then go out there and enjoy themselves and work really well with a client to do a great job. So that's what it's all about at the moment for me. Really.
So are you doing any recording or something, or it's just more just developing the idea?
It will be, the idea is ready to rock. It's we have the plan in place. I'm currently looking at all our online materials, redeveloping the PowerPoint presentations for the lessons. We want to make it nice and practical, so there's going to be a little bit of focus on them doing their homework at home, learning some of the theory. They'll come in, we'll teach them a little bit more theory, we'll consolidate the knowledge that they've got. And then what we really want to do is get them in the gym, get them working with partners, in pairs, with each other, and practicing the job that they are going to do.
Awesome.
It's all well and good swallowing a textbook and knowing every bone in the body and every muscle in the body and what does what, but if you can't turn that into helpful, practical advice for clients, then you know the question is, what are they actually paying you for?
So you said about your own training beforehand. So what you do? Do you do animal flow or?
I've been training for 15 years, 16 years in playing around with different approaches. You know, I started off with, as most young guys do, just trying to look good. Bicep curls for the girls.
Oh, are you doing? To be honest, is the first time I see you? It would have been like 3 or 4 months, and you look better. Like every time you come in here, you look better. Like, I don't know, whatever.
That's
it's
my
bigger.
Challenge for you to say that, mate. So, no, my training has evolved through going through traditional hypertrophy training to realizing that that didn't serve my body a great deal of useful purpose. You know, I got tight, I was getting sore as a relatively young person in early 30s. I think I should still be able to move quite freely. And so being restricted by doing too much bench press and pull-ups and all these kind of things, I decided that I needed to change. So, you know, a few years ago, I took up capoeira. That was the thing for me that really opened my eyes up to training in a different way, to focusing more on movement than focusing on muscles. I needed to develop my flexibility, I needed better mobility. So I stepped outside of my comfort zone and threw myself in, went back to my beginnings, become the humble student right at the bottom. You're the worst person in the class, but I like that. That. That's a nice challenge because I'm a teacher, I'm an educator, and I'm forever teaching others and trying to pass on knowledge, which I love doing. But it's sometimes great just to be the student for once, and you know, to be learning and learning about yourself, what you can do and what you can't do, and trying to be humble about the things you can't do, and using that as a challenge to improve, be better in whatever way you can, just be better. So my training took that turn, and nowadays I like to have a variety of workouts. So I like to get in the gym, I like to do my Olympic weightlifting, I like to do some kettlebell work, I like to do lots of animal flow, lots of body weight training, and then I go to the London School of Capoeira a couple of times a week and take a capoeira class. And
so it's like a massive mix.
Exactly that. And I guess, you know, I'm not particularly interested in being big, muscular, whatever. Everyone wants to look good, I want to look good, but I also want to be able to move, and the strength that I develop, I want to be able to do something with that strength.
So it's basically, it's possible to look good and still move well, yeah?
Definitely, yeah. That's it. You've hit the nail on the head there, mate. For me, it is about looking the part, because it's part of my job. You know, I teach people, I present. I'm lucky enough to fly around the world and deliver some presentations at conferences and conventions, and I love that, meeting all these different people. And you know, I think people do look at you and make a judgment about the way you look and present yourself, and there's nothing wrong with that. I think if you train and you educate yourself, use that information to better yourself, as well as those that you train yourself and those that you teach. So yeah, I like to mix it up, lots of different training.
It's kind of beyond training, isn't it? How's your diet? I know you're not eating today.
Fasting today.
We're going to pass the steakhouse, you know that.
No, well, you know, I could be tempted to break the fast if there's steak involved. You know that whenever I come to Edinburgh, I get straight down to steak restaurant in Bacardi Place, which is my favourite joint in Edinburgh. And the steak there is awesome, the Aberdeen Angus. So I'm a big steak fan. But for me today, I've decided to fast, because once a week, that's what I do.
So and, you're still doing this?
Yeah, I still do it. It's not religious every week, but then you know, I don't think anything in nutrition should be religious, otherwise you can't enjoy your food. I think you should have an approach, a structure, but also have some flexibility. Today's a fasting day. And the reason for that is that, you know, I stayed at an average kind of guest house, very nice, very comfortable. The food, however, was a typical continental sort of buffet this morning. So it was toast and jam and croissants and some very sugary cereals, and low fat sugary yogurts, which is, you know, a little bit of that from time to time is okay, but
because you travel so much, if you do this all the time,
exactly,
it would be so bad. So
it's not going to be the great. Yeah, so I choose to do my fasting day on a day when the food choices aren't the greatest. You know, we had a short break today within our animal flow course that you kindly were hosting. And, you know, again, there's not a huge amount of time to go out and find food. So for me, I will look ahead and think, okay, today's a great day to put a fasting day in. I can stay focused on my work. And you know, I can hopefully reap the benefits that fasting brings, or at least so some of the research suggests.
So in your no fasting day, what you do? What you eat? Like you?
Sure.
You wake up in the morning and what?
Well, yeah, so because my day is such a long day, and I'll get up and the first thing I'll do is if I don't have a really early client, then I'll eat at home and I'll have some scrambled eggs, I'll have some sourdough toast, if I've got some salmon, I'll get some salmon out, or maybe some bacon or something I've cooked the day before, mm-hmm. maybe some mozzarella, maybe some avocado, always got to get some veggies in there, tomatoes, asparagus, spinach, you know, whatever's in the fridge, but yeah. I guess I'm not rigid again on what I eat in terms of the particular ingredients. I'm more rigid about what does the plate represent. Mm-hmm. So if my plate represents natural, unprocessed food that hasn't really been changed in any way from its original form, and it's packed full of nutrients, and what I mean by that is there's some good, you know, colours on there. There's some green stuff. There's some red stuff. There's some orange stuff. There's some yellow stuff, and that's your fruit and veggies. And then also, if there's, you know, good sources of protein, mm-hmm. and a balance of carbohydrates, then it's
so
good.
It's sorted. Yeah.
That's it. You know, and for me, it doesn't need to be
like
any more
pizza.
Complicated. It may. Again, is pizza a bad thing? I don't know. Not necessarily. If you train hard and your weight and your body fat levels are kind of where you want them to be, mm-hmm. you can go to a pizza. I like Pizza Express. I think Pizza Express does some cracking pizzas because you can have, you know, your onions, you can have your tomatoes, your mushrooms, you can have your peppers. They do some grilled veg. I like whacking a bit of chili oil and mm-hmm. garlic oil on there. Chili and garlic are great, you know, nutrients for the phytonutrients
in those
herbs, in those seasoning condiments are great. You know, they're very health giving. So of course, you know, a big pizza's got quite a few calories there.
Yeah.
But it's about understanding where you're at, and if you're not necessarily trying to lose weight and your body fat levels are where you want them to be, mm-hmm. then great, have a pizza. You know, Jesus,
really,
man. You know, enjoy
yeah.
your food.
Yeah.
Yep. That's where it's at.
So it's like all your meals looks like that. So you're basically trying to. There's no diet you follow. You're just basically taking whatever it is, but you're trying to make it as healthy as possible.
That's it. Yeah, I'm a big believer that your nutrition should follow a kind of pyramid, and at the bottom of the pyramid for me. It's all the micronutrients, so that's basically your vitamins, your minerals, your plant chemicals, everything that actually feeds your cells of your body mm-hmm. and helps all the systems in your body that communicate with each other, that helps them work well. So I guess look at nutrients as like the WD-40 of the body. It oils the body, it keeps things ticking along, it keeps energy flow in abundance, it helps you be healthy and, mm-hmm. and avoid disease, right? Once you've got that and your body's working well, then you should feel good about going in the gym. So your body's going to be more responsive. And then once you are able to exercise regularly, you can then mm-hmm. start to think a little bit more about your macronutrients, which is your carbs, your fats, and your proteins. And again, I don't think that has to be complicated. I shoot for a relatively even balance of fats, carbs, and proteins. If I'm training and I'm mm-hmm. working out a couple of times in one day, or I've had a really hard training week, I'll probably bump the carbs up a little bit. I don't personally measure them. Some people do, and I get why they do that. But you know, I'm not interested in standing on stage and competing as a physique model.
Yeah.
And I've got friends that do, and they're awesome. And
to be honest, you're not that far from that.
I think
do you take any supplements or something, or is just all the natural things?
Yeah, I do. I'm a believer that use the right supplements uh-huh. at the right times, and they can be a great aid. Supplements are supplements, though. So if your nutrition is crap, then supplements really are just sugarcoating things. So you've got to get the diet down first. But yeah, supplements. I like a good multivit each day.
Mm-hmm.
I take a little bit of extra zinc and calcium and magnesium because they're macro minerals that we tend to have less of. That tend to be less available in the food we eat these days. That might be due to farming practice. It might be due to the processing of the food we
uh-huh.
eat, that sort of stuff. I take a little bit of extra vitamin D because vitamin D is probably closer to being a hormone than it is a vitamin.
Yeah.
A lot of scientists have found some crazy things about vitamin D, and we now understand how important that is, and the fact that, you know, I'm visiting you guys up in Scotland today, you probably get a little bit less exposure to sun than I might do. Just a little bit.
Yeah.
So I think it's
this
important.
This was the sunny day. Yeah.
Well, that grey. I tell you, yesterday was a cracking day though for getting out in Edinburgh and walking around.
Yeah.
It's beautiful. So a little bit of vitamin D exposure even at this time of the year in September.
But it's still not enough, isn't it? Even with the sun. They're saying you have to be outside for 30 minutes with the full sun exposure.
Yeah, you need the penetration of the UV rays to be strong enough, and that's typically only during, you know, a handful of months in the summertime.
Mm-hmm.
So it's why it's really important. I mean, you guys just went on your holidays, and I think you had a bit of nice weather, right?
Yeah,
and you got out on your bikes.
Mm-hmm.
So I think whenever you can, get your skin out, get some sun on it. Yeah, you know, don't be stupid and get burnt. If you feel like you're getting burnt, for God's sake, put some sunscreen on. And cover up, but you know, get out in the sun from time to time, and that's where you're getting the vitamin D, and that's
mm-hmm.
that's what's going to help, you know, with your skeletal health. It's going to help with a lot of people think vitamin D is great for avoiding disease, especially autoimmune diseases, and you know, it's a really strong vitamin that we need. So if you can't get it, I guess what I'm trying to say is, you know, a little bit of supplementation of vitamin D is fine. Oily fish as well is a great source of vitamin D. So is mushrooms. But so vitamin D I take. Yep. I use a protein powder after training. I dump a little bit of protein into a smoothie that I like to make. That's got some berries and some coconut oil and some Greek yogurt and I whack a raw egg in there. A bit of chia seeds, a bit of flax seeds. Grind it up. Use the NutriBullet. If you've,
mm-hmm.
I'm sure people have heard of the NutriBullet. Whack it in there, and you know. It's a quick way of getting some good nutrients in and keeping your protein levels up if you're training hard.
Yeah, and quite fast. That's we don't have NutriBullet. We've got something bigger, like it looks
right.
Like a massive one.
We've got some industrial NutriBullet.
Yeah. In the morning, we do this every morning.
Does your house shake a bit when you turn it
on? A little bit, but
and all the lights start to flicker from the power surge.
But probably if you drop there a spoon, like metal spoon or something, you wouldn't. It wouldn't matter.
It would swallow it up.
Go through, yeah. So it's quite.
Get your minerals from the metal spoon.
Why not?
Yeah, I like a smoothie, and I like experimenting. I like a greens juice. I've got a lot of time for those. When I popped in yesterday to Edinburgh, I was a little bit early before the course started, so I went into town, found a juice shop, and you know, I think we've got to be careful with juices and smoothies. That if you have a juice or smoothie that's fruit-based, you can take on a lot of sugar, and yes, you know, fruits are great for us, but taking on, you know, loads and loads of sugar, even in a natural form, is not great for you.
Yeah.
It's a big stress on the body.
Uh-huh.
But I think from a juice, from a greens juice that has vegetables as the base,
mm-hmm.
you know, there's less sugar overall there, and so I think that's a good option for getting nutrients in. Again, it's just trying to find ways to get nutrients in rather than a Coke or a fizzy drink or a soft drink. You know, if you can find a juice, have a juice. Some of them taste pretty good. You know, some of the green ones are pretty gross.
Yeah.
And you drink them because you know they're good for you, but some less so.
But this is not necessarily for taste, yeah?
Not for taste, more for nutrients and for health.
So if your clients, because you do personal training as well. Yeah,
yeah, I do train clients.
So if your client asks you that they want to drop body fat, what's the most important thing?
You know what, the most important thing with any goal, body fat is consistency. So whatever you're doing, my objective to start with is to change the mindset of the person so they do not expect that it's going to happen overnight, even the next day, even the next week.
Mm-hmm.
If you want goals and you want to hit them and you want them to be sustaining and you want those goals to stay with you, you can't adopt a certain approach to training or eating for 2, 3, 4, 5 weeks, whatever it is, and then just flick back to what you were doing before and expect those goals to stay with you. That's not going to happen. So my first conversation with a client is, okay, what do you want from this? Do you want to achieve a goal like lowering your body fat and for that to stay with you and for you to permanently look great, feel great? Or are we in a situation here where, okay, maybe you're getting married, you're going on holiday, whatever it is, and you just want to drop some weight relatively quickly. I can help them with both those things, but I kind of want to know their mindset. Where are they at in terms of what they expect from me and the way that I can help them, what they expect from themselves as well. And once I know that, then the important thing is trying to help somebody to be consistent. So we need to set habits and routines and things that they can do day in, day out, every day, that's not going to feel like a ball ache, not going to feel like a stress. I don't want someone to kind of get up in the morning and go, oh man, you know, I've got to do this, I've got to eat this, oh, I can't be bothered. The best diet is the one you can follow, right? Mm-hmm. And the best training approach is the one that you can follow and stick with. So first of all, I want to know, what do they like doing? What do they enjoy? Let's start there. Let's put lots of those things in that they enjoy training, that they enjoy eating. Let's get them into some good habits. And slowly, one thing at a time, we'll chip away. And we'll turn, you know, what they're doing now into hopefully what they should be doing. But that might be 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10 weeks. I don't know. Yeah. It depends on the person. It depends where they're at. You know, I've got to find out that information first. And we've got to do this in a way that works with their lifestyle, that isn't a stress for them, and it's something that's easy to do, something that isn't going to be a burden to them. And then they're more likely to stay with it. You know, if you have things that are effortless for you to perform day in, day out, then it's done. It's now part of your life. Yeah. It's like getting up in the morning and going for a piss, right? We all do it every single day because, one, we have to, and two, it's not that much effort, is it? You get up, you just go. So that's just what you do. You get up, you go to work. Now, okay, some of us might not want to go to work, we might not like our work, but we do it because it's what we have to do. Mm-hmm. So my perspective is, if I can get people to take on those habits and good habits, and they become part of just what you have to do, you don't even think about it, it becomes second nature, then it's ingrained. It's now a habit, and if you keep doing it day in, day out, 6 months to a year, you're going to get, hopefully, some way to where you want to be. And that's just the first step. The rest of it is the journey that you continue to take.
That's the only approach, isn't it?
You know what? It is. Ultimately, if you want to get down to business, you know, and we're being brutally honest, it is the only way. Yes, you can drop a dress size, lose a stone in a few weeks, but you take these extreme approaches that do work, but they are only ever short term because they're so extreme that you just cannot do it every day. Because it's so much effort, it's so extreme, the body doesn't like it, it begins to kind of disagree with you, and eventually you're like, oh, I've got to go back to what I was doing before, and then, you know,
it's going to hit you even harder.
Probably. And then you come back and see the trainer again and start all over again. You know, why do that? Yeah. Why not just, you know, let's sit down, have a conversation about how we can make this every day. This is what you do every day. Mm-hmm. Looking good and feeling great is what you have every day. That would be quite cool, right, for a lot of people. If I said that I could, you know, help someone to do that, and it's not a big effort, it's no secret, there's no magic to this, it's just, let's work this through together, let's think about these things, let's get a plan in place that's conducive to your lifestyle, and we take it as slow or as fast as we need to. Okay. Done.
Awesome. I'd like to be your client, you know. Those guys are lucky.
You're a solid trainer yourself, Leszek. I think a lot of people are going to benefit from. I've seen you train, and I've seen the classes you guys run down at the studio.
These guys need a personal trainer.
These guys on the bikes in front of us are looking like they need a bit of. Yeah, especially this guy's got some weight.
My God.
It's going to counterbalance him when he turns the corner, though. So maybe he needs that extra little bit of timber.
That's cool.
He's gone. He's off. Yeah. He's burned us out.
So, you're flying. Where are you traveling next after this? So, you deliver. What's Fit doing? You cannot decide where to go. Come on. You deliver courses every week, every 2 weeks, or?
For Animal Flow, we deliver courses regularly, every month or so, every couple of months. We are next delivering our course in London, but before then I am off to Bangkok presenting out there for fitness industry education, delivering some workshops on our small group exercise programs.
Have you been to
Bangkok before? No, that'll be great. I'm looking forward to it. I've just come back from Shanghai for 2 weeks, where I was working with a company who are going to be teaching personal training courses.
Okay.
And I was assisting them in helping them train up their tutors so that they can begin to teach the Shanghainese cohort. They call themselves Shanghainese, not Chinese.
Okay.
That was one of the little things I learned. I love meeting people and going to different countries. It's a great experience doing what you love and traveling around. And on the note of Animal Flow, we have our master trainer retreat in Bali in November, which is going to be awesome. So
sounds awesome.
Yeah, Mike Fitch and Karen Mahar, the guys that are the, you know, the creators, the owners, the directors of Animal Flow, they look after us well, and we're getting together the whole team, and we're off to Bali to do nothing other than Animal Flow for 4 or 5 days, dude. You know, we've got an amazing retreat. It's up in the hills, up in the mountains. The mist is going to rise from the forest every day. The monkeys and the birds, they're all going to be like going crazy.
It's only for masters then.
For the master instructors, for us guys to get together.
Not good.
Sorry, dude.
For us?
Well, maybe next time we'll invite you down. You got to get your level 2 certification.
I know.
Yeah, and then maybe you can qualify as a master instructor teaching courses up in Scotland. But that's going to be great, you know. It's going to be cool to hang out with the other guys. The team is so strong. The master instructors are so strong. They're all great professionals in their own right. And we'll have this commonality of we enjoy movement, we appreciate movement.
Yeah.
And Animal Flow is the format and the program at which we express our movement training. And, you know, as I say, it's awesome just to immerse yourself in the program and get better and learn from each other and come out the other end of it being hopefully a better instructor. That's my goal. And also to improve my own technique, skill, knowledge, and and it will allow me to be a better tutor and presenter off the back of it. And we'll have a few drinks as well, mate.
Why not?
We'll get around the table, sink a few bottles of wine, and have a few beers. I'm sure. Why not? We'd be rude not to it. So I have Bali. I also have Toronto that I'm going to, and I'm taking the fascial stretch therapy course, which is delivered by Kevin Darby and Darby Training Systems over in Canada. Great company. Kevin's an awesome tutor. So I'm looking forward to learning a little bit more about how the body is made up, how it's wired, and trying to understand how the way the interconnected nature of the body affects movement, and how if we understand what the body's made up of, and how the body communicates with each other, if we can understand that a little bit more, we can use this therapy technique to reduce injury risk, improve again movement, joint function, muscular balance, and so on and so forth.
So is this like a training system, or more just the muscular system and physiotherapy thing?
Yeah, it's a therapy approach, but it's manipulating the myofascial system. So myo just relates to the word muscle.
Oh yeah, yeah.
Fascia relates to the fascia that covers, like a wrapping that covers the body, and the myofascia is like an interconnected.
So are you actually working with the patient, or are you working on him? So basically, you're using your hands to manipulate. Or?
Yeah, you're on a bench, you're on a couch.
Okay. Yeah.
A massage couch. That's it. Yep. And you're moving the limbs in these patterns to try and move through the myofascial lines of the body, or the sling systems, as they're sometimes referred to. And if you know how to move through the right directions, you can help just to kind of, I guess, it's like oiling the body, like we said earlier. It's oiling the body, getting the tissues sliding over each other, and creating better freedom of movement, so that when you get up off the couch, the body's much more responsive and fluid in the way that it can respond. So I can't wait to learn some of this stuff. It's something that I don't know a huge amount about, the basics, and I want to add a new string to my bow. Always, trying to learn some new stuff and improve what I do, improve the services I offer my clients. So Kevin's great too. He's a very knowledgeable guy over in Canada, and I'm looking forward to spending a week with him and learning some cool shit.
Superb. We need to stop. I can see you could be talking like that for hours.
You won't you won't shut me up if we don't if we don't wrap it up.
And it's so interesting. It's like, yeah, I could listen to you quite a lot. And then especially I like your voice and everything. It's nice and
it's,
I just like it. Yeah, it suits me. But anyway, we are on the airport already.
Oh wow, so, man, that went so quick.
Yeah.
Leslie, thanks for hosting us again this weekend, man. Your studio is awesome. You guys are doing some great things. I love the classes. I think anybody in Edinburgh should get down to the studio and check out the workshops and come and see you guys for some PT if they need some assistance, man. It's
thank you for
it's
that.
Great.
And you know, anytime you are here, you are always welcome to come.
I will.
Yeah,
absolutely. I want to come and do some of those kettlebell workshops as well that you guys run. But yeah, it's been great to chat, man.
One thing, all these names you mentioned, if you could just send me an email with them, so we can just post them under the podcast. Okay.
Right.
So
names of the experts. Yeah.
And some links as well.
Right.
So we can just link them.
It will be
better for people to easier to find them.
Yeah, sweet.
And where people can find you? Like, do you've got any website or Facebook? What's the best way?
Facebook is the best thing. I don't have a proper website yet. I need to get one.
Yes, I'm nice. Go.
go.
3, 2, 1. So the Facebook.
Yeah, Facebook's easiest for now. Yeah, I'll get around to some kind of website at some point in the future when I stop doing courses and stop training and get some time to sit down and do it.
And then, yeah, but Facebook is enough. It's just it's
a website,
so
isn't it?
And it's a website, and got all the info there. Anyway,
sweet. Thank you, brother.
Thank you.
It's very
much.
Generous of you to give me a ride. I appreciate it.
Oh, this is Sunday. There's nothing to do. Yeah. I have to just ride.
It's cool to have our chat on the and this will be quite a cool.
It should be cool. I don't know. I never done this before, as I said. So hopefully it will work fine, and we'll see.
Sweet.
You will see it first. Thank you very much. Cheers. I'll have you with that.
Yeah, cheers, dude. Hopefully the plane's on time.
Yeah. Said it's been a long, long, long life in the sun. Finally evening comes, so we sit around back and read a book and hold a joy. Soon you know me not to take no chat from no boy, cause me don't have a plan for them. And it no mean me I go say no man for them. Cause if I book them, I read and I treat me like clown. Who say we have to take it lying down? Knowledge is the power, we control the tower, and rival Elizabeth crown, yeah. Better. Rise with the wind like a feather. Fly with the eagle, then we sing like a bird. Things are to get better. Up, me say, step on the elevator. No matter what the time or the weather. Fly with the eagle, then we sing like a bird. Gloom and dismay, you slap him with a book. All evil same way, you slap him with a book. Determination on display.
Things can be better,
better. Rise with the wind like a feather. Fly with the eagle, then me sing like a bird. Things are to get better. Up, me say, step on the elevator. No matter what the time or the weather. Fly with the eagle, then me sing like a bird. Troops them reply, disrespect. All I call man boy, I rather sing one song for them than make my family come sing no song kidding. Because enough them sink and I pass along down. That's when you got to take it lying down. But knowledge is the power, we control the tower. So don't make them catch you spellbound, cause
things will be better,
better, better, better. Rise with the wind like a feather. Sing like a bird, things are to get better. Up, me say, step on the elevator. No matter what the time or the weather. Fly with the eagle, then me sing like a bird. One thing you should know is that I never give in. No.
look, you see gloom and dismay. We slap him with a book, all evil same way. We slap him with a book, determination on display. Sing like a bird.